Live from Rad Sherman Field at Kirsch Rooney Stadium in New Orleans, Crescent City Sports is proud to bring you high school baseball. This afternoon, it's the best of District 9-5A, a doubleheader here on Crescent City Sports, starting off with the Jesuit Blue Jays against the Holy Cross Tigers. And a pleasant good afternoon to you, Ken Trahan, joined by Kirk Bollinger, the former major leaguer, as we get set for the first of two games here today. And not bad to get two for the price of one, and two outstanding games in an outstanding league in District 9-5A, beginning with one of the oldest rivalries you'll find anywhere in the country, Holy Cross and Jesuit. Kirk, great to have you with us, and you've been there, done that. You've seen this one a million times from the time you were a kid. This is a great rivalry, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Thanks, Ken. I appreciate you having me back again for this doubleheader in the Catholic League. Looking forward to it. Seen these teams a ton, and there's no better rivalry in the country.
Well, it is, and no doubt, and it's a cloudy day here, but look, from the standpoint of these two schools, you don't have to get ready to play because of the enormity of the rivalry for so many years. They have played one game already, and it was a 4-0 victory for Holy Cross this past Saturday behind Jake Gegenheimer. Pitched a complete game victory, which was pretty special to shut down this Jesuit lineup because it's a good hitting baseball team.
They are. They're very, very scrappy. They don't strike out a lot. They have a couple guys in the lineup that can deliver the long ball, especially in their park. It'll be a little bit different playing here tonight, especially with the wind blowing in. But very, very contact-oriented club. And Jake Morisi is going to have his work cut out for him facing this Holy Cross Tiger lineup.
Clearly, it's going to be a game where both teams need to win the game to stay in contention for the district championship, because this league is bunched up as we speak. The standings are such. Archbishop Rummel currently on top at 7-2, with Brother Martin a half game back at 7-3, and they play the second game of this doubleheader we'll present to you here from Kirsch Rooney Stadium. John Curtis Christian, the hottest team in the league, they're 6-3, so just a game out. Then you've got Holy Cross and Jesuit, both 5-4, so still in it. Only two games out of first, so the winner here today is clearly still in the race. Then you've got St. Augustine at 4-6. Carr has completed its district schedule at 0-12. Lights are on here as we do have a cloudy afternoon here in Lakeview. But again, when you look at this particular matchup, you look at players to watch. And let's first of all talk about some of those players. So Holy Cross, you know these guys very well. Brody Forstall has been playing for quite some time now. He's a senior now and has played extremely good baseball for this team. Trace Thomas the same way. I mentioned Gegenheimer. He pitched the gem the other day. He's a senior. Tom Pellegrin, just a sophomore, but he's already, of course, a two-lane commit. Lucas Altafirmaggio was an all-district player a year ago. So these are some of the players for Holy Cross. Aaron Guichard, a senior, so they've got a seasoned team. They've got guys that have been playing for a while for this program.
They do, and even the younger guys have been playing. Like you said, Don Pellegrin's been a starter. This is his third year now. Started as an eighth grader, batted in the three hole as an eighth grader, so you know he has matured as a player. Cirkovich as well has been starting since a very young age. Brody Forstall finally healthy. And it shows. If you look at the numbers that he's been putting up this year, it's been night and day. And it just goes to show you what happens when you do have a healthy Brody Forstall. And then, of course, Altafirmaggio, Luca, is the power bat. You know, he's the guy that provides the thump. And he had a great year last year. I think he led the district in RBIs. He was an all-district performer, and you expect more of that to come this year from Luca.
His brother Nico, of course, starring at Nichols as we speak. Big shout-out to Joey, his dad, and a good friend who sports much of the things that I do here on a professional basis. Meanwhile, for the Jesuit Blue Jays, look, they won the state championship in Select Division I a year ago, and it is a younger team, but it is a good team, and it has good players. And the thing that sticks out for Jesuit is, you know, you look at the top four guys in their batting order. You're talking about 371, you know, 400, 384, 356. That's some stout players. Everett Denny, Derek DeLatte, Marshall Serio, Patrick Berrigan. They have the ability to hit the baseball and score runs.
They do. They always do. And again, they're a very disciplined team. They're a very well-coached team. Those guys have a game plan every single night, every single at-bat. And they're going to find ways to beat you. They've been doing it for 100 years. They did it last year in the state championship to take down the Rummel Raiders after a great performance by Brady Schmidt, who you've seen a lot of this year with the Delgado Dolphins. So taking him down, taking the Raiders down was awesome for the Blue Jays last year. And although they're young, they're still right in the thick of things this year.
Let's go ahead and present the starting lineups to you as they exchange the lineups at home plate. First of all, Holy Cross, the visitor here today with a record of 12-10, 5-4 in District 9-5A under the direction of Aaron Barres, who submits this lineup card. Leading off in center field is Brody Forstall. Christopher Cirkovich in right field will bat second. Dominic Pellegrin, the shortstop, hits third. The cleanup hitter and first baseman, Luca Saltafromaggio. It's Ryder Blanchard pitching and batting fifth. Denny Trusclair, the DH, will hit sixth. Aaron Guichard is in left field batting seventh. Hitting eighth, the catcher, Jeffrey Lewis, and batting ninth at third base is Rue Guerra. Luke Appy will play second base and will not bat. Again, top three, Forstall, Cirkovich, Pellegrin. Middle three, Saltafromaggio, Blanchard, and Trusclair. Bottom three of Guichard, Lewis, and Guerra Appy at second. For the Jesuit Blue Jays, a record of 17-10, 5-4 in District 9-5A under the direction of Kenny Gundlett, who submits this lineup. Leading off at first base is Everett Denny. Batting second at second base, Derek DeLad. Hitting third, your shortstop is Marshall Cirio. The cleanup hitter, left fielder, Patrick Berrigan. Batting fifth, the third baseman, Connor Donnelly. Hitting sixth, the designated hitter, Joe Bosco. Batting seventh, and doing the catching will be Luke Whirling. Hitting eighth in center field is Michael Brothers. Batting ninth and doing the pitching will be Jake Marisi. Brandon Thomas will play right field and will not bat in the lineup. Top three of Denny, DeLatte, and Cirio. The middle three, Berrigan, Donnelly, and Bosco. And the bottom three, Whirling, Brothers, and Marisi, with Thomas in right field. Jesuit will be in there. Well, do I need to say what Jesuit's in? Of course not. Pinstripes, there we go. That's easy. Blue Jays with their familiar look. And, of course, Holy Cross will be in their road. Grays here today with their navy blue tops. And old gold print with the navy blue caps as well. So there's your color distinction for this afternoon, Kirk. As they continue to talk it over at home plate, we'll get you set for things. We're looking at the weather conditions here today. The skies are cloudy. We have not had any precipitation. Fortunately, doesn't seem to be any in the area, and let's hope that stays that way. The temperature is 79 degrees as we speak, and the wind is a factor. It's out of the southeast, and that means it's blowing in, which means it's going to be more difficult to get the ball out of here today. It's 7 miles an hour out of the southeast, and it's gusting to 12 miles an hour overall. So that's the wind condition to pay attention to, and do a lot of games here, whether it's high school or Delgado games, and we see all the time about the wind conditions factoring in. And certainly it looks like an indoor ball game today as far as the weather conditions are concerned. As we get set for lineups, we'll see the crowd filing in. We'll get you some crowd sound here in just a bit here as we get things rolling. Stay tuned for that. So, Kirk, I mentioned the 4-0 game that they win at Holy Cross Park. And you've seen those games at Holy Cross Park over the years, and it really is a place that can play one of two ways. I mean, you've seen games there where it's hard to score and games there where you better keep scoring. It's one of those parks, Holy Cross Park.
It really is.
Between the Holy Cross Tigers and the...
It really is. If the wind is blowing in off the lake, it is tough to hit balls out of that park. But if the wind is blowing out there, then it becomes an airport, and things are checking out regularly. And
second, right fielder, Chris.
It makes it very difficult to pitch in that park at times.
Batting third, shortstop, Dominic Pellegrin. Batting fourth, first baseman, Luca Saltafromaggio.
Starting lineups being introduced as we speak. And then we'll have the anthem and then the start of the game. So we'll start a couple of minutes late in terms of starting time. The second game is not slated to begin until about 7:30, so there won't be enough time. Typically, these games are played in pretty good time because these teams play the game well, and they pitch and catch the ball pretty well overall. I mentioned the league standings, Kirk, coming into this one. And when you talk about the standings, I mean, you saw how tightly bunched they are with these teams doing what they're doing. And obviously now you've got, 7-2, 7-3, 6-3, 5-4. You got literally five teams within two games of the lead here.
Should we expect anything different?
No, what else is new, right?
I mean, so that's what we do.
Yeah.
I can't tell you how proud I am to have been a part of that as a player and as a father and now as a fan in general.
No doubt. And, of course, this ballpark, I mentioned the weather conditions, and when you study this ballpark as a whole, at large, it typically plays very fair, if not big. The infield can be hard here, depending on it. Now, if you're an infielder, you've got to come get your hop. You cannot sit back on the ball here. And it's interesting because Jesuit, of course, typically plays at John Ryan Stadium, but that stadium is out of commission with the damage to the turf, and they hope to have it finished, I'm told, by the summer, but it's going to be this whole season. They're not there. So when they move their home games to other facilities, including a lot of games here, it plays totally differently because of the fact that it's a grass surface, a good surface, not a hard infield and a dirt infield, and you've got to come get your own hop here. If you stay back on the infield, you're going to be in trouble here.
Yeah, and that's any grass field in general. I mean, unless you're playing in a big league park. I mean, you want to come get the ball. If you get a big hop, you want to come get that big hop. And I honestly think over the years, Jesuit playing all their games on an AstroTurf field has put them at a disadvantage when they do go on the road and have to play on a grass field.
For the national anthem by the Jesuit High School Choir.
Our invocation coming up, followed by the national anthem performed by the Jesuit High School Choir.
Of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, we ask you to bless our athletes, bless our coaches, bless our families. We ask you to keep them safe as they play on the field today, and allow the hard work and the dedication and the virtue and the discipline that they exemplify on field and off the field inspire them in their lives to come. We ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
St. Ignatius Loyola,
pray for us.
St. Joseph,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
School Choir performing our national anthem to get things started here this afternoon. Lights are on here at the ballpark and will be throughout the course of the game as one of the great rivalries in Louisiana is set to take place between Holy Cross and Jesuit. Strap it on, stay with us. We'll be with you for quite some time as, of course, we have two games, a second game to follow between Archbishop Rummel and Brother Martin here, along with Kirk Bullinger, Ken Trahan. A shout out to Dan Kane, our producer here today, and to Sam Tornator, our camera person. As the Blue Jays take the field, they'll do so with Berrigan in left, Brothers in center, and Thomas in right. It's Donnelly at third, Sirio short, Delatt at second, and Denny at first with Whirling doing the catching. And on the mound is the right-hander, Jake Marisi, who takes his warm-up tosses. 5'9", 160-pound junior, and Kurt, you've watched this young man since he was a freshman. We know his dad very well. And he's not going to blow you away. He's just going to throw strikes and make you beat him, right?
Yep. And I'm going to correct you. I've watched him since he was about four.
Is that all?
And it's been a pleasure. It's been a pleasure watching him mature as a baseball player, as a pitcher. It's been wonderful. He's a great kid. Comes from a great family. We all know Ryan in the Hall of Fame at Archbishop Rummel. We go way back. But no, his son, he is a competitor on the mound. He's a bulldog. He won't blow you away, but what he does is command everything he throws extremely well. He basically works with a four-seam fastball, a curveball, and a changeup that he will throw in any count. And that is really his outpitch for me.
Ready to roll here, leading it off with the Tigers is Brody Forstall at 288, a homer, 9 driven in. First pitch of the ball game is a fast strike. We're underway at 408. So 0-1 to Forstall, lefty swinger, good player, veteran player, starter for quite some time. 0-1 pitch, breaking ball beat on the ground to second. Delatt bobbles, can't recover. So an error starts the game and a base runner for the Tigers. Well, we talked about not letting the ball play you. That ball wasn't hit very hard, Kirk. And
that was a good breaking ball. Brody was out in front of it, hit off the end of the bat. And right as Delatt was about ready to reel that one in, it came up on him and hit him off the heel of the glove. And when you do that with Brody's speed, you're not going
to
get him.
To my point, right away, come get the ball here on this infield. Christopher Cirkovich, the right fielder, bats at 220. No homers, 5 driven in. Forstall, good speed, a lead. And a bunt toward third. That is hugging the line, and it is a foul ball. And the third base coach is swearing that ball was fair. That was very close now. The third baseman, Donnelly, could have let it go a little further to see if it would go foul for sure. He tagged it right near the line, was ruled foul immediately by the home plate umpire, much to the chagrin of the Tigers, and it's no balls and a strike. Very close, Kirk.
Yeah, third base coach and head coach of Holy Cross, he jumped up immediately. It was very, very close. And the third baseman should have allowed that one to roll. He should have retreated a little bit with the ball, Donnelly should have, to make sure that there was no question.
Well, Aaron Barris is a mild-mannered guy, and he definitely reacted there. This is lined into right center. Center fielder on the move, won't get it, a base hit. Run around second. Forstall's trying for third. The throw is on the mark. He's safe. Throw to second. He is out of second base. A good relay throw gets him at second base. Delatt slaps the tag, or rather, not Delatt, but it was Delatt, slaps the tag on the base runner on a good relay throw from third by Donnelly for out number one. Couple of close plays there.
It really was. The ball was blooped out into shallow center field. Brothers makes a nice throw to third. A little risky with nobody out for Forstall to try to take third. And then trying to sneak in the back door.
Cirkovich.
With Cirkovich, who was out rather easily. He might have...
Here's Pellegrin. This ball's in the dirt, and it hits the umpire's leg, and that might have saved a run for Jesuit. That ball would have gone back toward the backstop. 1-0 to Dom. 328 hitter. 1 homer, 5 driven in. Early commit to Tulane. Open stance right side. The pitch almost hit him. Tried to throw the breaking ball. Didn't break, and it's 2 balls and no strikes. We see these early commits, Kirk, and Dom Pellegrin committed to Tulane very early. I want to say his freshman year. After his eighth grade year.
Yep, sure was. You can't do it anymore.
2-0 pitches pop straight up. This is on the infield. A big out here for the Blue Jays. First baseman wants it. Putting it away is Denny. That's a huge out. The second out of the inning.
High fastball. Couldn't get on top of that. Skies it in the shallow infield. Easy play for the first baseman, Denny, who normally plays third base or catcher or pitcher. He's played all over the infield this year.
Here's Lucas Salta Famaggio fouling the first pitch to the netting. Salta Famaggio, 279, no homers, and 14 runs driven in for Luca. Straight up defensively now. They're shallow around the outfield. We mentioned the wind's blowing in, Kirk, so it's going to play that way. 0-1. Swing and a miss. Chase the high heat, 0-2. To that point, even more so, you want to challenge hitters here today.
Oh, absolutely, and Jake knows that, and that's exactly what he's done. He's thrown a bunch of strikes already.
0-2 is up and away. Tried to take another inch or two off the plate and climb the ladder. Neither worked. It's 1-2.
The Tigers really did the Jesuit Blue Jays a favor by being ultra-aggressive.
Breaking ball sits high and tight, 2-2. Doesn't look like he has the feel for that curveball yet.
He's throwing a little bit across his body right now, and it's not allowing him to finish that breaking ball. If you watch, he's working from the far first base side, but when he strides, he's middle of the mound.
Popped up first base side, running out of room is Denny. And the count remains 2-2 with 2 outs here in the top of the first inning from Kirsch Rooney Stadium. Salta Famaggio's driven in 14 from the full windup. Jake Morisi with another swing and a miss. He got him with a fastball out of portion and gets out of it with no runs and a hit and error. One man left, bottom of the first coming. The Tigers nothing, and the Blue Jays coming to bat. He made his pitch.
He did. He made the pitches he needed to make right there. None bigger than the 2-0 pitch to Pellegrin to get him to chase in a hitter's count right there and pop up on the infield, which would not allow Forstall to advance.
So a real opportunity for Holy Cross goes by the boards. And now the Tigers take to the field in the bottom of the first inning with Guichard in left. It's Forstall center and Cirkovic in right. Guerra at third, Pellegrin short. Happy second, Salta Famaggio first. Lewis, the catcher on the mound, is the right-hander, Ryder Blanchard. And Blanchard, very impressive numbers on the year. He has made 7 appearances, but only 1 previous start. But he is 3-0, and get this, perfect earned run average. 16 innings, he's allowed 1 hit, 1 run unearned. He's walked 10, struck out 10, hit a couple of batters. So only his second start, but that's eye-opening when you've gone 16 innings and you've given up 1 hit and no earned runs.
That is extremely impressive from Blanchard. And he basically features your three regular pitches, right? You get your fastball. He's got a little bit of a, as they call these days, a sweeper, which I call a slider or a slurve, because that's kind of what it is. And then also the traditional changeup. So pretty textbook stuff. But with those types of numbers, that tells me one or two things. Number one, he's getting ahead. Number two, he's staying ahead. And also, number three, he's locating the ball very, very well.
Everett Denny leads it off at 371. He has a home run, and he's driven in 19 on the season. Left-handed swinger Denny stands in. First pitch, breaking ball, missed the outside edge to Everett. Now a senior, 6'2", 180. Good size, versatile player, good player, solid pitcher as well. 1-0, missing away, 2 and no strikes from Blanchard.
Both pitchers working from the far first base side of the rubber. Kind of a trend that's going on these days.
2-0 misses down and in, so now 3 and no strikes. What's the advantage there?
Well, a lot of people think the advantage is being able to get the ball to your glove side, which it can help. But for me, it's something that you should only do when there's a deficiency in your mechanics or your delivery.
Strike called. It's 3-1 as Denny was taking. Might be swinging now. Garrett cheats in at third. Is the 3-1. Swings at it, lines it down the left field side, slicing into the corner. That is a foul ball. Diving effort by Guichard. But it's about 3 feet foul.
And the wind, so the wind's full 3-2. It's pushing it a little bit because it's blowing in from center field right now as it looks. So it's going to knock anything in the air down and push it a little bit. Foul on the left field side and as well on the right field side if it's not squared up well.
Denny running hard all the way, just getting back to the plate to reclaim his bat. 3-2 the count, leading off the bottom of the first inning here at Kirsch Rooney Stadium.
I think Everett's grown an entire foot since he entered Jesuit High School.
Payoff pitch is rolled foul over toward the Holy Cross dugout. We'll do it again. Down the third base side, you'll see the new clubhouse facility going up here at Kirsch Rooney Stadium for Delgado. It's beautiful, and it's going to be a tremendous asset. At this ballpark into the Delgado program. Anytime now.
Anytime.
Fastball away, so there's a leadoff walk to Denny. Battled, saw 7 pitches, trots to first. Blue Jays have the leadoff man aboard.
And as soon as we compliment a young man on being a strike thrower and commanding the ball, he goes out and promptly walks the leadoff hitter of the game.
You did it.
Put the mouth on him. I put the mouth on Ryder.
Here's Derek DeLatte, the second baseman, having an outstanding season for the Blue Jays. Derek hitting at 420. Pitch is wild inside. It actually got a piece of DeLatte. He'll trot to first, hit by pitch. Those are the kind you love to take for the team. That just grazed DeLatte, maybe on the jersey, and he's fine, and it's two on, nobody out. And there goes Lewis to the mound.
Yeah, I was going to say that would warrant a trip from somebody, and I'm sure with the limited number of trips that coaches have these days, he gave Jeffrey Lewis the sign, go talk, calm him down. And again, he hasn't had a lot of starts this year.
Bump situation, Marshall Cerio, good hitter though, 384 by far, leads the team in RBI with 26. No homers for the shortstop, who waits. He is going to swing, and he takes it over but low for ball one.
You know, and this is one of those situations where the starting pitcher has not proven that he can get a guy out right now. So I think that's probably the thought in Coach Kenny Goodlett's mind right now is if he can't get a guy out, I'm not going to give him an out.
Cerio, a sophomore, waits for the 1-0, and here it is. Swing, another foul down the first base side. He was jammed badly.
Looked like a little two-seam fastball that Blanchard ran in on the hands of Cerio. Hit that one right off the tape.
Marshall wears number one on that pinstripe jersey. Stands upright from the right side. Runner at second. Denny DeLatte at first. Blanchard pitches, and a ground ball to second is a double play ball. Flip to second, one. Back to first, two. 4-6-3 double play. Happy Pellegrin, Salta Formaggio, twin killer, two outs, Denny to third, and Berrigan will bat.
And that was just a get-me-over curveball right there by Blanchard, letting his defense play behind him. Well, as you said, with the wind blowing in, didn't want to mess around right there with Cerio. Got the routine ground ball to second, easy double play, 4-6-3.
Here's Patrick Berrigan. At 359, 27 RBI. He actually has one more than Cerio to lead the team, so they're 1-2 in that department. Breaking ball strike, it's 0-1. Berrigan, outstanding hitter, left fielder for the Blue Jays, senior now.
If I remember correctly, he had the game-winning hit in that state championship game last year.
You might remember that a little bit. It seems to me that you may have been there with me. No balls and a strike, here it comes. Breaking ball down and out. It is one ball and one strike.
There's the breaking ball right there.
Interesting, too, because William Good is at Tulane now. Bryce Pitts, their other fine pitcher at Delgado now. Brady Schmidt is at Delgado. Breaking ball down, blocked nicely by Lewis. Keeps the runner at third. It's 2-1. The principals in that particular game, Schmidt's been lights out for Delgado. He had another scoreless frame against, a scoreless appearance, I should say, against number one LSU Eunice this past weekend.
Yeah, I think it was, what, 1 1/3, I think he threw in that game?
Two balls and a strike on Berrigan. Pitch on the way. Ooh, he just missed the inside edge, and it's 3-1.
He's got a little bit of arm side run going on today, and that's going to be important. That will set up that breaking ball that he possesses.
Good hitters count for a good hitter, the 3-1. Swings at it and chops it foul first base side. Jammed, and it's full 3-2. We've seen a few hitters jammed early on.
Yeah, and you know, at the high school level, a lot of pitchers just stay away. They want to stay away from the power. So if you can command the ball in and pitch in effectively, you'll see a lot of that.
From the stretch, Blanchard payoff pitch. Swung on and missed, and a breaking ball, and he gets out of the jam. No runs in the inning. No hits, no errors, and the Blue Jays strand a runner after one. We're scoreless from Kirsch Rooney Stadium. And that was a good job by Blanchard to pitch around a walk and a hit batsman to start the inning with the other team's best hitters up. That's tough to do. He did it.
Yep, so both pitchers pitching around the leadoff and the two-hole hitters getting on base. The only difference was there was that Holy Cross kind of ran themselves out of the inning, whereas Jesuit hit themselves out of the inning in with that double play.
Blue Jays back in the field defensively. Amorisi, who settled in a bit, will go back to work here. And he'll be facing Blanchard, Trostler, and Guichard as we go to inning number two. No score here from this one in high school baseball on Crescent City Sports. Is brought to you by the Lamarck Motor Company in Kenner. Lamarck Ford, the number one Ford dealer in the Metro New Orleans market. Must be a reason. Everyone comments on my Lamarck Broncos sport. Just running out so you can't miss it, right?
Yep.
Yeah, I figured you.
Raider blue.
Something like that. Here's Ryder Blanchard taking one just outside for ball one. Blanchard, the pitcher for the Tigers at 246, no homers and nine driven in for Ryder, a junior. Open stance right side, out of a crouch, the pitch. That's a fast strike, and it's 1-1. Straight away defensively are the Blue Jays. Lights on, wind blowing in his mention. And the 1-1 pitch. That's right down the middle. It's 1-2. And these dimensions here, this is a college ballpark. 325 down the lines, 370 to the gaps, and 400 to center field.
It is a triple ballpark, I'll tell you that.
1-2 is a breaker down and out, and it's two balls and two strikes on Blanchard.
Lots of triples in that right center field gap. And as shallow as they're playing right now because of the wind blowing in, if you hit anything in the left center field gap, there's a pretty good chance that's going to be a triple as well.
Foul back to the netting. It's still two balls and two strikes on Blanchard, leading off the top of the second inning. Another pitch. Swinging a fly ball to right. Had him gauged perfectly. Thomas will put it away. One out. Soft contact. Pitching him away. As you mentioned, that's going to be the ticket here today. It is most of the time, as you mentioned, on this level, except for the power pitchers who can use the inner portion or even throw it down the middle, but not the case here. You don't have true power pitchers today.
No, neither one of these guys are power pitchers.
Ground ball foul first base side by Trostler.
But what Morisi does very well is he mixes his pitches so well, and he throws his off-speed for strikes. So that allows that fastball that's low 80s to play much faster than that when he does use that fastball.
No balls and a strike on Denny Trostler, the DH. The pitch, breaking ball foul to the netting, and it's no balls and two strikes. Morisi challenging him and getting ahead.
And it's funny because, you know, even though he's a low 80s guy, he can still pitch effectively up in the strike zone. He changes eye levels very well, and that's what the changeup and the breaking ball do for him.
0-2 the count. Here's another on the way. Ground ball toward first, foul. So we'll do it again at 0-2. Then he chased it, but it was foul off the bat.
And he's beating Trostler right now with that fastball. Trostler's choked up. An inch or so, maybe a little more on the bat. Fastball in right here is probably going to beat him, too.
Swinging a liner in the right. That's trouble down the line. That's fair. Into the corner. He's going to run for a while. Rounds first. Heads for second. He's going to be there with a stand-up double. Denny Trostler lines a double to right, and here come the Tigers.
And that was a curveball. It was a bit of a hanger, especially with that 0-2 count. That's not a pitch that Jake wants to make. He's trying to get that ball on the corner, off the corner. Instead, it stayed front side. And Trostler did a good job staying inside of that ball and lining it down the right field line.
Now an opportunity for Aaron Guichard, the left fielder. 159 with seven driven in on the season. Cheating in at first. Pitch on the way. Outside of ball, 1-0. Surprised that they're cheating in so much with one out in the inning?
Yeah, I don't know why they are. I mean, if they're bunting, I would welcome that with open arms.
1-0 the count.
Especially with a shortstop on the mound.
The pitch. Fast strike. It's 1-1. Perfect location.
You see how fast that fastball looked right there? You know, it's probably only 82, 83, but it looked like it was about 86, 87.
One one, down and out with a hook. It's 2-1.
Just missed with that off-speed pitch. Good take right there by Guichard. After he threw the fastball in the same spot, the pitch prior to it.
The pitch, missing high and away, and now it's three balls and a strike on Guichard.
And it's not a big deal if he loses Guichard. He's got a base open. It would set up the double play, so you don't want to give in to him. You've got the 7-0 hitting catcher in the on-deck circle.
3-1 is down the middle, and it's full 3-2. Guichard could not pull the trigger. Lewis is on deck. Trusclair at second with one out here in the second of a scoreless ballgame. Guichard waits for the payoff pitch from Maurice. Here it is. Swing and a miss. He got him, stayed away, and gets his second strikeout and gets the second out of the second inning.
Good breaking ball right there. That's the one he wanted to throw to Trosclair a little bit earlier in the previous at bat. That ball, again, started middle away, and he broke it right off the edge of the plate, and Guichard ran out of bat.
Jeffrey Lewis, the catcher, 171, three driven in on the season, the pitch on the way. Strike called over the outside edge. He's found the touch of the field, if you will, for that breaking ball now. And sometimes it takes an inning or so to do that. Got out of that jam in the first and trying to put up another zero. Maurice.
He shook off a couple pitches right there. Might be an automatic shake to the heater, and it was.
Away for a ball, 1-1. Well, what you mean by that is, of course, sometimes teams will try to deceive opposing teams because they know each other pretty well, right?
Yep, and a lot of times the coaches are calling the game, and if you see a pitcher shake, it's a called shake.
Ball's down and out, it's 2-1. Sure, he's telling them to do so that the opponent does not think they've got a beat on what you're doing.
Yep, and if you see it enough, you know that it's an automatic shake to a fastball, more often than not.
2-1 is fouled back. It's even up at 2-2. No one tries to steal signals. We know that. I mean, come on.
No.
It's never happened before.
No,
it's never going to happen.
And nobody bangs on trash cans.
No, that doesn't happen either. Why are you still on that? Huh? You pitched in that organization. Come on, man.
No.
2-2.
You do what you have to do to try to win the game, right?
I understand. Stretch and the pitch. Breaker down. It's 3-2. For their sake, I'm glad it just gets further down the road. I still had to go out and execute. I don't like it, and I lost a little respect, if not more than a little. At the same time, they've backed it up by playing really good baseball for several years.
I blame it on the opposing teams. If you're that
3-2.
Out of it.
Swing and a roller toward the mound. Hold that thought. Easy chance for Maurice. Underhands to Denny to end the threat. No runs and a hit and a runner left. That's two stranded now for Holy Cross. We're on to the bottom of the second. And still no score here from Kirsch Rooney Stadium. All right, so now you can talk about it extensively. Now,
if you're the opposing pitcher or opposing team, or let's just say you're the third baseman in Minute Maid, you're close to that dugout. If you can't pick up on garbage can banging on off-speed pitches, and you're that unaware of it, something's wrong with you. You know, you've got problems, because that tells me that you're not into the game and you're not paying attention to detail, because that should have been a dead giveaway early in ball games. And all you do is simply send a message. When you hear a bang and it's supposed to be an off-speed pitch, you don't throw the off-speed pitch and you buzz a tower, and the banging will stop immediately.
Tell me how you really feel.
That's how I feel. I mean, we saw, you know, guys trying to steal signs from second and relaying them to the hitters.
I mean, I'm getting texted by the Ultimate Astros fans.
Who's that?
He's saying, come on. I'm not going to give away names, but he was here earlier.
Oh, okay.
So it's all good. So no problem.
No, I love the Astros.
You got to understand CrescentCitySports.com, okay? You got the Ultimate St. Louis Cardinals here for life. But I'm very respectful. I love Major League Baseball, as you know. I'm very respectful. And I was an Astros fan for years growing up as a kid, but also because I called their AAA games for many years.
Right.
That said, I'm a Cardinals fan. Have been since I was a kid and for life. But I've got a website where I've got two guys that are my primary guys that we work together as a team that are big Houston Astros fans, okay? Both of them. One of them's named Jude Young. The other one will remain nameless. Lenny Van Gilder. So, all right.
Now, I love the gamesmanship. I love the Astros. I love Minute Maid. You know what? But the reason they did it was they struggled offensively.
Oh, my. Got drilled by a pitch. Fortunately, turned his head just in time. Got hit at the top of the back, and Connor Donnelly will trot to first.
Maybe Plancher heard a garbage can getting banged.
Mm-hmm. I said Continentale. Joe Bosco and is up now. So good that he took that pitch where he took it. Yeah, Donnelly is aboard.
Upper back, he's good there.
Yep. So Connors at first, hit by pitch. That's a second hit batter already by Blanchard, and here's Bosco. 256, he has 11 RBI. Took a breaking ball down and out. That's a good job by Jeffrey Lewis. Look where he ended up.
Way out by the apron.
Bosco. Really good job by Bosco, or rather by Lewis, to save that wild pitch. 1-0 count to Bosco with Donnelly at first. Nobody out the pitch. Swinging a foul. It's 1-1.
Bosco just a little tardy on that. He's a big, solid young man. 256 hitter. Doesn't have a homer. Does have one double, one triple in his 10 hits.
1-1 the count. And goes through the signs once more. Not ready. And a fast strike. And it's 1-2. Of course, our archaeologist's son in town from Austin, Texas, and of course pointed out to him about that home run you gave up, so he went and looked it up. Took a look at it. He said, it wasn't a terrible pitch. I said, no, it wasn't. This pitch is high. Wild pitch back to the netting, which means Donnelly will get to second base. So hit batsman and a wild pitch and runner in scoring position with nobody out.
Jesuit's in business right here. That was a breaking ball that Blanchard really, really got around and was not able to finish it, and it went behind the head of Bosco right there. Lewis did everything he could to reach it, couldn't get to it.
And he laid off the breaker down and out. Nice stop by Lewis again. It's 3 balls and 2 strikes. You know, the Busch Stadium 2 played big. Did you think that ball was going to go when he hit it?
I wasn't sure because he hit it so low.
He hit it so low. It was a line drive. I first thought no.
Yeah, I didn't think it was out until I saw the fans in the center field stand up. Then I knew it was out.
Packed in the netting, holding at 3-2.
I was looking at my center fielder, and when he turned his back, then I knew I was in trouble.
Did you learn how to speak French, by the way?
Not at all.
Not at all, huh? You got a lot of that?
Pointed to everything on the menu. Give me that.
Such is Montreal. 3-2 the count, stretch and the pitch, and a swing and a line drive to left. Hit hard. That's a base hit. Throw to third. Runner safe there. Good job by Guichard to short hop that shot. He's limping a little bit out there. Let's hope he's all right.
He might have stuck a knee in the turf right there. That wasn't a bad pitch right there by Blanchard. It was a fastball kind of in on the hands of Bosco, but he's so strong, he muscled that one out in the shallow left. And you're right, Guichard made a great job of picking that on the short hop, because if that gets by him, it's going to be trouble.
Yeah, he's going to run for quite some time. Instead, it's first and third. Nobody out, and a chance for the Blue Jays with Luke Wuerling. He's had a good season, 320 with a homer and 11 driven in. Runners at the corners, nobody out. The pitch outside and high. It's 1-0.
Blanchard's going to be looking for another double play. He would happily give up a run for a two ball right here.
Swing and a foul, 1-1.
We saw the other night in the Romo Brother Martin game, double play was probably one of the biggest plays of the game. There were a few. That was probably the biggest defensive play for Brother Martin, with McCluskey coming in, catching that ball right off his shoe tops and turning it into a double play.
1-1, and he hits his third batter of the game, Wuerling to first. So 3-hit batters already, nobody out in the second inning, and a big opportunity for Jesuit, and Aaron Barres is going to come to the mound.
Nobody's down in the pen.
Well, I mean, you've got position early players that could be your next guy up. Jesuit's going to run at first base with Sean Mayer. So Mayer's going to run at first for Wuerling, the catcher.
Yeah, that was just a fastball that Blanchard yanked. Looked like he was trying to get it in on Wuerling. And like I said, that's the good pitch to throw right there to get that double play, to induce that double play. But he just pulled it a little bit too far and caught Wuerling in the thigh. So bases loaded, nobody out. Blue Jays are in business. And this is the type of game that the Blue Jays can play And they that's what they do. They play small ball, very fundamentally sound, and you make mistakes against them, they're going to make you pay for it.
Well, accustomed to playing in a ballpark that dictates that at John Ryan Stadium, where they cannot play this year because of the turf issue and waiting for insurance and everything else, but that's a huge ballpark. It's all turf, and it's, with all due respect, pretty easy to play the infield there. And the outfield is very spacious, so pitchers challenge hitters. They've got good pitchers, and they catch the ball.
Yeah, I hope.
So thus, it translates into having to play small ball.
Yeah, I hope the next application of AstroTurf there is better than the previous, because the previous one was
spongy.
So slow.
Very spongy, yeah.
It grabbed the ball. It didn't allow the ball to travel through.
Here's Brothers, big spot, high and away, ball one. Michael Brothers, 260. He has a home run, and he's driven in 12 on the season. Big opportunity here. Donnelly third, Bosco second, Mayer first.
Brothers does a great job of staying inside the ball. His best power is up the left center field gap.
Took it high and away. It's 2-0. No need to swing here.
Yeah, he's got to be very, very patient here. And really keyhole planted right here. In other words, look for one pitch in one spot in this 2-0 count.
Big inning possibility here. 2-0 to Brothers. Here it is. And he took a strike. It's 2-1.
Really good pitch right there by Blanchard, right on the outside corner. Home plate umpire Shane Rigdon gives him the benefit of the doubt right there, and it did look like a strike from here.
Got the A game out here with Shane behind the plate. 2-1 the count. The pitch missed the inside edge, 3-1.
And that was the pitch he was trying to throw to Whirling in the previous at bat that he pulled a little bit, made an adjustment on that one, just missed.
Has to throw a strike here with the bases loaded, nobody out. 3-1 the count. And the pitch, Brothers takes ball four on a close pitch, and the Blue Jays take a 1-0 lead on a bases loaded walk to Michael Brothers, who collects his 13th RBI of the season.
That looked like a really good pitch right there by Blanchard. I don't know exactly where that missed. The only place I could think it missed was in by a hair. It was not high, and it definitely wasn't low.
Jake Morisi.
Now Jake Morisi can help himself. 267, he has 9 driven in. Bases loaded, nobody out. The pitch, and a good breaking ball, and that's another pitch. I guess missing up, it's 1-0. Walking behind the mound is Blanchard. You can see his frustration.
That was a ball.
Called a ball, it's 1-0.
Wow, that was a get-me-over curveball right down the middle. Might have to go to the robo-ump soon.
1-0. Swinging a fly ball to center. It's not deep. Forstall has it. Runner tags from third and not coming. Good idea. Forstall right on line with his throw. Ball just wasn't hit deep enough. And Jesuit didn't want to run itself out of an inning there. So a big out obtained by Blanchard. Out number one.
Yeah, fastball in on the hands right there. Morisi a little over-anxious, probably wishes he would have taken that because it didn't look like a strike. That looked like it was in and probably a little up. In a 1-0 count right there, got to be a little bit more selective.
Here's Everett Denny, walked his first trip. Base is still loaded, one out. Pitch on the way. Everett takes it in the dirt. Blocked by Lewis. One ball and no strikes. Now the 1-0. Outside and high, two balls and no strikes. To 2-0. That's high and away. Now it is three balls and no strikes with no room on the bases. So no question, Denny will take at least one pitch here.
Looks like number 0 down in the pen, Trace Thomas for the Holy Cross Tigers.
3-0's up and in. It's another bases loaded walk, and the Blue Jays take a 2-0 lead as Denny gets RBI number 20. Bosco crosses the plate. Mayer to third. Brothers to second. Merry-go-round continues. And here's Derek Delatt, who was hit by a pitch his first time.
Second baseman, Derek Delatt.
Blanchard struggling right now to find the strike zone, and the Jesuit Blue Jays have been very, very patient, except for that one at bat this inning.
Fair strike. That's what he has to do, is get ahead in the count. It's 0-1 to Delatt.
And that's what we talked about pregame. That's what he had been doing.
This is Jesuit's best hitter on the season. Delatt waiting from the left side. Here's the 0-1. Swinging a chopper up the middle of the second. Second baseman can't handle it. One run scores. Second run from the plate. He scores. And the Blue Jays take a 4-0 lead. You can't assume a double play, so that's an RBI. Got to be an error on the second baseman. So an RBI for Delatt, his 19th on a fielder's choice. And then the error allows everyone to proceed with two run scoring.
Little chopper over the mound. Second baseman came in on the run, tried to glove it, and the ball stayed down on him, but he didn't stay down with it, and it gets under the glove of App, and that allows two runs to score, and the Blue Jays are really in business right now.
Runners break, the pitch, a strike, and a double steal for Jesuit. So aggressive base running, Denny to third, and Delatt to second, and the Blue Jays try to build an even bigger inning.
And I will bet right there that Everett Denny looked in and saw that a breaking ball was coming, took advantage of it. He took off. I don't think that was a planned double steal. I think he went on his own, because if you looked at the break that Delatt got at first, he was way, way behind Everett on the break. And typically when that happens, you really want to throw down towards second base and not third base. You want to get that trail runner, because he has to wait until the runner at second ahead of him takes off. But there was no throw on either of those base runners.
Long conversation at the mound. This has been a nightmarish inning for the Tigers. Only one hit, but four runs home, and a chance for more for Jesuit with only one out of the inning.
Yeah, you know, when you give away that many free passes, you know, five of them in the inning, including the error, four with walks and hit batsmen, and then you compound the problems with the error at second base, and it turns into a big crooked number. And those numbers are tough to rebound from.
Here's Marshall Cirio, grounded into a double play, I should say, in the first inning. Second and third, one out. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball down, 1-0.
He's just steering that breaking ball in right now. He's not throwing it at all. It looks like he's lost all confidence in it.
Trace Thomas throwing with a purpose now in the bullpen. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Fastball strike called, 1-1. To Marshall Cirio.
Not a position you want to be in as an infielder. Infield in with the three-hole hitter in the batter's box. I had to do that one time against Russ Johnson at the old Alex Box Stadium.
Down and out. 2-1.
I looked into the dugout and asked Coach John Stevenson for a catcher's mask, because I'm going to tell you what, that infield back then was rugged.
Ooh, it was
hard. Rugged.
It was hard.
And we didn't have the type of firepower on the mound to beat that type of team. And Russ Johnson and Wes Grissom,
ooh,
he hit one off my wrist. That was not fun. That was probably about 108 off the bat, maybe more.
Did a lot of Russ's games for the New Orleans Zephyrs. Very fine player, good hitter.
Great hitter.
Two balls and a strike on Cirio. Infield is in, and a lot of time being taken, so Cirio steps out. Now settles back in. Four runs home already for Jesuit.
They're
trying to get some more.
They're about to bat around as the eighth hitter of the inning.
And he took it over but low. So Cirio, again, close pitches not going the way of Blanchard. It's 3-1.
Home plate umpire isn't helping Blanchard at all in this inning. Not at all. Been some questionable pitches. I mean, he's kind of done it to himself, because he's been a little bit all over the place this inning. And when you are doing that, it's hard to get those borderline calls.
The pitch. chopper to the third baseman, and he's got the runner caught up in a rundown. Runs him back, and he got the tag. Well done. Didn't have to make a throw. That's what you want to see in a rundown right there, Kirk.
That's it. As few throws as possible, and in that case, it was none. So that's exactly what you're looking for. That's going to go unassisted. U5 for the second out of the inning.
Mm-hmm.
Nice play by Rue Guerra. If you don't have to throw it, don't throw it. You can get the out without throwing the ball. Definitely want to
use it. Left fielder, Patrick Berrigan.
Well done. Here's Patrick Berrigan to the plate. Stretch pitch. Breaking ball just missed the outside edge. Berrigan struck out swinging in the first.
They chased that high curveball. His first at bat.
5-0 lead now as, of course, Denny crossed the plate. On the rundown play, that is over but high, so it's 2 balls and no strikes. And there's a strike called, it's 2-1.
And you know, on those mound visits, the pitching coach and the head coach were just trying to tell Planchard, don't try to be so fine. Use the ballpark. It's a big park, wind blowing in.
Swinging a pop foul back, it's 2-2.
And honestly, I mean, nothing has been hit real hard this inning, and the Blue Jays have thrown up a 5 spot.
Roscoe got the base hit. It's the only hit of the inning, the only hit of the game for the Blue Jays, but they've got 5 on the board.
And that one was muscled out into shallow left field.
Runner goes, 2-2 is away. The throw down is accurate but safe at second base with a stolen base is Sirio. So 3 steals in the inning for the Blue Jays.
That was a good throw by Lewis. Happy looked like he tried to tag before he actually had the ball. And the ball scooted away from him. Pellegrin was there to back it up. But a successful steal.
3 balls, 2 strikes. Hitter steps out. Boy, he's taking a lot of time. Seen a lot of step outs.
He's thrown a lot of pitches this inning. He really has.
And the payoff. And he struck him out looking. Good pitch, fastball. But the Blue Jays bat around as they score 5 runs in the inning, doing on just 1 hit in the inning. There was a key error and a runner left. 2 stranded for Jesuit after 2 Blue Jays on top, 5-0. Well, Kirk, that's going to be a mountain to overcome here, down 5 on a day with the wind blowing in.
It really is. And the only way you can do it is to chip away. And you know, every at-bat has to be a quality at-bat. You can't give away at-bats. It's only a 7-inning game, and you're down to 15 outs now. And Marisi's starting to settle in, so they're going to have to make him work. Put a little pressure on the Blue Jays like they did to the Tigers in that inning.
Blue Jays took full advantage to take the 5-0 lead here.
Planchard's at 53 pitches after 2 innings, and I bet you he threw 33 of them in that inning.
Tigers need to get something going. Rue Guerra will get it started here. In the top of the third before Forstall and Sirkovich come to the plate.
He threw 14.
Ross Guerra.
He threw 14 in the first. 39 in that inning.
Here's Guerra. Here's the pitch. Swinging a fly ball, slicing down the right side. Right fielder chasing, foul ball, and no play. Climbs with that fence pretty hard. Good effort by Thomas. Hit that side fence, he's fine. It's no balls and a strike. Side fence also has a little gate opening from the bullpen there, so that was right about where he was going to collide with the fence. Wind's changed a little bit. It's still blowing in, but now it's a little bit toward right. No balls and a strike, thus the ball slicing a little bit there. Here it comes. Swinging a foul back. So quickly, Maurice ahead of Rue Guerra, 0-2.
Yeah, 14 pitches in the first, 39 in the second for Blanchard.
Guerra, 400 hitter with three RBI coming in. 0-2. Swing and a fly ball to right. On the run toward the line and diving effort. Berrigan unable to get there as he's running to the fence. Now he face plants. So he's getting a workout down the right field side.
He almost got that left wrist tucked up underneath him as he dove for that. And he did take the glove off. That didn't look good the way he rolled over that wrist.
Good news is Brandon's okay.
Yeah, it looks like he is.
And right about now he's telling Guerra, hey, straighten it out, man. I'm tired of chasing these. Third baseman Donnelly came over, had a brief word with Maurice. Makes his way back up the hill.
Maurice beating Guerra with those two fastballs. A fastball in right here. Probably going to beat him in.
0-2. Swinging a pop foul back. And out of play.
Wasn't supposed to be in, but it wound up in and it jammed him. Popped it up softly into the screen.
Holding in no balls and two strikes, and another from Maurice. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a breaking ball. So one time through the lineup, three strikeouts for Jake.
Curveball under the zone. Great location right there. I was just about to say it would be a good opportunity right here after that high fastball to bounce a breaking ball. He didn't bounce it, but it was under the zone enough to get Guerra to swing right over the top of it.
There's Brody Forstall, reached on in error. In the first was stranded, and he takes a strike called on a breaking ball. That's 0-1. Maurice able to get ahead of most hitters thus far. The 0-1. Breaking ball hit hard to first. Nice play. Denny to the bag unassisted for the second out. Good contact from Forstall. Denny, nice play. And two gone for Christopher Sirkovich. Singled his first time.
Right fielder. Chris,
the only time you can put a third baseman by trade over at first base, you're going to get pretty good defensive play, and that's exactly what you saw right there.
Pitches just off the plate away, 1-0. Great to have versatility on your roster. There's the 1-0 pitch. That is low, and it's two balls and no strikes. The 2-0, missing down, 3-0. Seen that with the games I do here for Delgado with the versatility of players like Logan O'Neill and Rhett Centeni, who's moved to third base. Strike called, it's 3-1. Logan plays second, can play right, pitch, play anywhere you put him basically. And Centeni's been a terrific first baseman and right fielder, but he's been outstanding at third base. Popped up into short right, should be easy for the right fielder, Berrigan, who puts it away. Thomas, I should say. An easy inning for Maurice. Nothing across in the top of the third. Bottom half coming. Still 5-0. Blue Jays on top. Maurice does exactly what you want, Kirk. After getting that five spot, he gets the shutdown inning.
He sure does. And the biggest part of that inning was he fell behind 3-0 to Sirkovich right there. Came back. Grooves a fastball. Sirkovich was taking it all the way, especially being down 5-0. And then he promptly serves another one up. And again, when you have the wind at your back, you can be ultra aggressive. And then you add a five spot on it that you got in the bottom of the second, can even be more aggressive. And that's exactly what Jake Maurice did in the top of the third.
On to the bottom half of the third inning now. Blanchard back to the mound. It's been a struggle. He's hit three. He's had a wild pitch. And then, of course, the walks as well have been a problem. Three of those. He does have a couple of strikeouts to his credit. Connor Donnelly starts the third. He was hit by a pitch and started that five-run rally last inning. Blanchard stretched but then stepped off. He's really been a slow worker. I just don't think he's been all that comfortable. Now he's going to go from the windup. missed inside. It's interesting. He went to the stretch, and then he stepped off, and then he went to the windup. It's 1-0.
Yeah, very unusual to see that. But that shows you that his head is not in the game right now.
1-0 the count. And the next one. Look out, he hit another batter. So that's the fourth hit batsman, and the second time he's hit Donnelly in as many at-bats. It's just a breaking ball. It didn't break.
Yeah, and he's just not getting it.
And that might be it. I think we're going to get Trace Thomas, who's been warming up for the last inning or so for Holy Cross. Got to believe they're going to make the move here.
Again, it's a breaking ball. He's just not accelerating through at all.
Yep.
Again, throwing across his body a little bit, working on that first base side of the rubber, isn't allowing him to get through that breaking ball. And then when he slows his arm up, it compounds the problem.
So with the pitching change, we want to remind you that high school baseball in Crescent City Sports is brought to you by Rhino Shield in Mid-South. Tired of painting year after year? Go Rhino! Rhino Shield resists chipping, cracking, flaking, or peeling, and is backed by a 25-year warranty. Get your free estimate. Visit RhinoShieldMidSouth.com or call 833-233-7181. To the mound, Trace Thomas for the Tigers, taking over to try to stem the tide, if you will. Looking at the numbers on Thomas on the year, he's been very busy. 7 appearances, and he's made 5 starts. The record is 2-3. The ERA is 5.76. No saves, 20 and two-thirds innings. 21 hits allowed, 21 runs with 17 earned. The issue is 18 walks. He struck out 19 and hit a couple of batters on the season. So clearly all about command here for Thomas to be successful.
Trace Thomas.
Or the Tiger. He's a good-looking kid, 6'2", 195, the senior.
He's a big boy. He is penciled in to be one of the pitchers on the Gibbs Construction roster this year for the summer.
We'll have Danny Ream with us a little bit later on for our second game. We have second game of a doubleheader to come between Brother Martin and Archbishop Rumble here on CrescentCitySports.com. And, of course, speaking of Gibbs Construction, we'll praise them here as we move along because we deeply appreciate Larry and his longtime support of our games here on CrescentCitySports.com. Could not do it without him and couldn't do it without Lamarck Motor Company and Ronnie Lamarck and Ronnie Jr., Ray Hoffman, of course, Rhino Shield, you know about them, and Kevin Mamahat, and all those that have supported us to make this possible for so many years now. Greatly appreciate it. It's our pleasure to bring it to you, as we do to our mass audiences, always free. And the advertisers enable us to do that. And here is Joe Bosco, who singled and scored in the second inning. That's the lone hit of the game for the Blue Jays, who have a 5-0 lead.
One hit, 5 runs. It's tough to do. Tough to do.
You say it doesn't add up, but yes, it does. Stretch. Pitch. Double play ball is short. Not hit hard enough, though. Second for one. Do they have time? Nope. A little wide of first. So you get the 6-4 put out. Pellegrin happy to take care of Donnelly for out number one. One pitch gets him an out. Bosco will run at first. And Luke Whirling will bat.
Good fastball away. Bosco just beat it into the ground. Pellegrin had to come in on the run. Gloved it cleanly. Had trouble getting it out of the glove. Looked like he threw a fingertip ball over to second base. I think that upset the timing of that double play, which allowed Luke Appy to pull the first baseman, Salter Formaggio, off the bag.
Here's Whirling taking it high. He was hit by a pitch in the second inning, and the courtesy runner, Mayer, ended up scoring. For the Blue Jays, wind is howling in now, straight in. Look at that. Flags are just howling. So you're going to see outfielders play shallow all day and all night. Ground ball right side. That's a base hit. Runners are going to end up at first and second base. For Jesuit with one out is Whirling. Punches one through to 3-4 hole.
Yep. Happy playing closer to the bag for the double play right there. And Whirling just rolls it in the hole. didn't hit it sharply, just hit it in the right spot, hit it where there ain't. And that's exactly what Whirling did. And Jesuits got runners on first and second here in the bottom of the third, putting a little bit more pressure on the Holy Cross Tigers again.
Sean Mayer will run at first, and here is Michael Brothers, walked to drive in a run and scored a run in the second. Two on, one out for the Blue Jays. And the pitch, showed bunt, took a pitch away, 1-0. Not a bunt situation with one out, but maybe just showed it to him, we shall see.
Probably just trying to draw that third baseman in a little bit. We know Brothers likes to hit the ball the other way, and he is in on the grass now at third.
Showed bunt again, it's 2-0 as this one's down. He certainly has the attention of the corner infielders. Guerra third, Salta Famaggio first, both cheating in. Two balls and no strikes. And the pitch. Bunsen and Dean, it's a dandy toward third if it stays fair, but it is foul. And it's 2-1. It just caught the lip of the grass. Once it did that, it's going to slice foul.
Yep, as soon as it rolled off the grass, that was it. But a very, very well-placed bunt.
Yeah, if it stays on the edge of the grass, it's going to be fair, but it caught the lip, and once it did, it automatically sliced foul, barely. And yep. It's 2 balls and a strike.
He's at the friendly confines of Jesuit's normally home field. That ball's probably going to be a hit.
2-1 pitch, going to swing, and he shoots a fly ball to left, right to the left fielder, Guichard, makes the catch. Again, they're going to be shallow, and thus far any fly ball is carried right to the outfielders. For the second out of the inning here, and here's Jake Morisi. Flew out to center his first time.
Pitcher, Jake Morisi.
Brothers hit that pretty well the other way, but it's not going to go anywhere today.
Unless things change, nothing in the air will go anywhere. Runners lead first and second. Moss goes second, Mayer first. Pitch on the way. Wild one. Runners are going to advance to second and third. Tried to throw the breaking ball and just yanked it. Lewis could not corral it. We're two runners in the scoring position now. First wild pitch against Thomas, second for the Tigers.
Morisi with an opportunity to help himself right here, big time.
1-0 is a fastball over but high, 2-0. Elects to work from the stretch. With runners at second and third, 2 balls and no strikes. And another on the way. That's right down central. It's 2-1.
Big 2-0 pitch right there to get himself back into the count somewhat.
Had to.
He's got the lefty on deck. He really needs to try to end the inning here and not turn that lineup over again.
Thomas ready, 2-1. Man, that just missed the outside edge. It's 3-1. Jesuit has shown tremendous patience at the plate in this game.
And we talked about that in the opener. You know, that's what they do. They're very disciplined at the plate. They do all the little things right.
Now the 3-1. Swinging a pop-up right side. Shallow right fielder toward the line. Cirkovich makes the catch. And the inning is over. No runs. And a hit, two men stranded for the Blue Jays. They've left four, and after three, Jesuit 5-0 over Holy Cross here. Greg Sherman Field at Kirsch Rooney Stadium.
Jesuit 5, Holy Cross.
Just celebrated a few days ago. What would have been another birthday for Rag Sherman, a phenomenal human being, a guy I just absolutely love. Awesome. I don't know that I met a better person than Rags. He's such a good man. Great baseball coach, make no mistake about it, but he was so kind.
He was.
Lovely guy, man.
He was great. I had the pleasure of traveling with the Johnstown team years ago. That was 1984, if I remember correctly. Yep, 80. No. What year did UNO go to the World
84.
Series? 84.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it was,
yeah, it was some guy named Jim Bullinger.
Yep, so it was 84.
Right.
I was able to make that 27-hour bus trip to Annapolis, Maryland, and then on to Johnstown, Pennsylvania. What a blast I had as a 14-year-old, wide-eyed. I had a great time. It was awesome. And they wound up winning the championship against a very good Johnny's Baltimore team.
Mm-hmm.
Had somebody on the team by the name of Wally Whitehurst. He was pretty good.
He wasn't too shabby, was he? Blanchard went 2 innings plus, only 1 hit, 5 runs, 3 earned, walked 3, struck out 2, and a wild pitch, and hit 4 batters.
Dominic Pellegrin.
Dominic Pellegrin starts the fourth. He popped to first his first time. Arisi, 47 pitches, 3 strikeouts in 3 innings. And he delivers, just missing the outside edge. Not getting that half ball to ball off the plate here this afternoon. 1-0 the count. It's been a tight plate. That is a strike, and it's 1-1. Arisi unfazed.
Yeah, the other night we saw that ball and a half off. Today we're not seeing it at all.
1-1. Breaking ball, strike call, 1-2. A ball and 2 strikes on Pellegrin. And another on the way. Line drive, base hit, left field. Tried to climb the ladder with a fastball, and Pellegrin just got that bat up to it and hammers it to left.
Fastball up and out over the plate. Pellegrin has really good bat-to-ball skills. You'll see that the more you watch him. Doesn't swing and miss very often at all, and that's pretty evident from his numbers. Only 7 strikeouts on the year.
That's it. He puts the ball in play. Now you get an idea of why he's committed to Tulane to play at the next level. And here is Lucas Saltafromaggio. Struck out swinging in the first. Swinging a fly ball. Should be easy into center field. Brothers there. Put it away. 1 out. 1 pitch out.
That ball was hit pretty good, actually. And it didn't go anywhere.
Not going to.
First pitch swinging. Jake Marisi's telling Luca, thank you very much. Keep hitting it in the air.
Second baseman.
Now Ryder Blanchard. Now playing second base. He flew out to right his first time. First pitch is down and out, 1-0.
Next game is going to be interesting with that wind playing in like that. Both teams like to hit the long ball a bit.
This ball is just outside, another close pitch, 2-0 to Blanchard. Yeah, we'll see what the conditions are like then, if anything changes. The second game to follow this one is Archbishop Rummel and Brother Martin. 2 balls, no strikes. Here's the pitch, and that's a breaking ball strike. Able to throw the breaking ball down in the count and get it over for a strike. 2 balls and a strike now.
If you can throw behind in the count breaking balls for strikes at the high school level, you're going to have a lot of success. That, along with the changeup.
2-1, outside and low. That one not close, and it's 3 balls and a strike.
He cut that fastball. He even made a little hand gesture after he threw the ball. He knew what he did. Let's see if he can make the adjustment.
3-1 on Blanchard, and the pitch, and a swing and a foul. It's 3-2.
Another breaking ball looked like right there. Behind an account.
That one might have found General Diaz. Count full, 3-2.
Tell you, that was one of the worst things about playing at this ballpark when you were a sophomore and you weren't a starter and you were in the dugout having to go
chase the balls.
Chase
runner
the
goes,
balls.
Pitches inside, so ball 4. So it's 2-1, 1 out. Blanchard draws the walk, the first issued by Marisi. And now a chance for the Tigers. 2-1, 1 out for Denny Trostler, and he ripped the double on a liner to right his first time. You had to chase a lot of balls, huh?
That year I did. I tell you what, it motivates you to play better. I'll tell you that. You want to get in the lineup because the last thing you want to do is be running down the blacktop streets of New Orleans in spikes. It's not good.
Here's Denny Trostler. As I mentioned, doubled his first time. 2-1, 1 out. And he took it just down for a ball. Well, when I did the Zephyrs games, my son was young. He couldn't track any down because there were a lot of people there in those days, a lot. Mm-hmm. But when I did University of New Orleans games for years, he got a whole bunch of foul balls there at Main Street Field, Privateer Park. Here it comes. Chopper, it's worth third foul. It's 1-1.
Again, right there, Maurice goes back to the behind in the count breaking ball, throws it for a strike, gets a swing, evens the count at 1.
5-0 Jesuit here in the top of the fourth inning. Slated for 7 in District 9-5A. As mentioned, the winner stays in contention in this league race. A ball and a strike. Ready with another. And he took a strike, got the call over the outside edge. We haven't seen that call pretty much all day yet, but got the call there, and it's 1-2.
Yeah, that one was up and out. Maurice taking advantage of that. Let's see what he goes back with there. I'm looking breaking ball away.
1-2 is a breaking ball, fly ball to center. Should be easy for Brothers. There to make the catch. And the runners will hold first and second with 2 outs. Again, anything in the air is pretty much death here today.
Can of corn right there. Brothers did a very good job of working his way around that ball just in case the base runner at second, Pellegrin, decided to be adventurous and tag up and go to third, but thought better of it being down 5.
Baron Guichard struck out swinging in the second. That's with 2-on, 2 outs. Long look, longer look, time call. Oh, he tried to get time, didn't get it. Runner breaks for third, throw to first, they've got him. Oh, they call him safe. They call him safe at first. Ball beat him by a bunch. But able to just get in under the tag, apparently Blanchard. So it's a stolen base for Pellegrin on the front end. Whirling saw the space at first base. He likes to go with the back pick throw, and it looked like he had him, but the tag by Denny apparently was high.
Yeah, we just saw 2 bad calls right there. Home plate umpire should have given timeout to the batter right there, Guichard. There was no reason why he shouldn't have. It was way early enough. That got the runners in a bad position. So I'm really glad that the first base umpire called him safe first base, because it wasn't the base runner's fault there.
Here it comes, swinging a foul back.
He should have been called out, but I think justice was served there.
Guichard trying to do some damage with 2 outs and get his team on the board here. Guichard ready to stand back in. Maurice nods yes. And the pitch. And he just missed the outside edge. Again, around the plate.
He just missed that one. Just missed.
Yeah, 1 ball, 2 strikes.
I don't know how you take that one, I'll tell you that. The only reason you take that one is because you can't hit it. It freezes you.
Going to hold the runner at first now. They were behind him. But now they'll hold.
And that's the inexperience of Everett playing first base. He doesn't play there regularly, so. Right. Coach Goodlett reminding him of his duties with runners on first and third.
1-2 is grounded to second. The plate is second for the force. Galat DeSirio takes care of the Tigers here in inning number 4 with no runs and a hit. And 2 men stranded, 4 left for Holy Cross. We're on to the bottom of the fourth, and the Blue Jays maintain the lead at 5-0. Maurice just doing the job, Kirk.
Yes, and once he got that 5-run second inning, you've seen his approach change a little bit. Not trying to be real fine. He's attacking the strike zone, letting his defense play behind him, and he's got a good defensive team behind him. So why not? I mean, he's just been doing a great job of throwing strikes. If he does get behind in the count, the very next pitch is a strike. And a lot of times it's been an off-speed pitch for a strike in the 1-0 count.
Now Maurice now 66 pitches. He's struck out 3. He's walked 1, and he's in pretty good shape in this game, not just on the scoreboard, but in terms of pitch count to be able to go deep. Trace Thomas back to the mound for the Tigers here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Jesuit will have the top of the order up with Denny, Delatt, and Sirio against Thomas in relief of Ryder Blanchard. Get you caught up on some of the numbers in terms of power rankings in this select Division One classification. We all know that, pay attention, that it's all about Catholic of Baton Rouge being at the top of the heap. That goes without saying, with the kind of team it has and how good it has been all season long, coming off of a semifinal loss to Rummel a year ago. Been really good. And of course, Catholic is sitting way ahead of everybody in Division One right now in the power rankings, well on their way to a top seed. John Curtis Christian right now is number two. Captain Shreve, three. Northwood of Shreveport, fourth, with Archbishop Rummel, fifth, and Brother Martin, six. St. Paul, seven. Jesuit, eight. Tioga, nine. Alexandria, 10. Riverdale, 11. Holy Cross at number 12 as we speak. Here's Everett Denny. Two walks, a stolen base, a run scored, and an RBI. Been in the middle of a lot. He takes this way off the plate.
Just goes to show you how deep this district is.
Well, it really is. I mean, St. Augustine at 15 is a dangerous team. Want to know the count?
They got the right guy on the mound. They definitely are. Hmm.
Ready the pitch. That is over below. It's 2-0. The catcher, Lewis, trying to frame it. Two balls and no strikes.
That one just missed right down the middle.
Might have been in touch low, but good pitch. Now the 2-0. That's down and out, 3-0. Denny will certainly take a pitch here. Three balls and no strikes. Bottom of the fourth, 5-0 Blue Jays. And the 3-0 pitch. And a strike is called. It's 3-1.
Boy, as a hitter, you hate to take that 3-0 cookie right down Broadway.
He's leading off the inning. He's walked twice, and he wants to get on again. Thomas with the 3-1. Denny swings and hits it high and deep to right. Right fielder playing shallow. Back. Track at the wall. This ball's gone. Everett Denny over the American Legion sign. And right field hammers one. His second home run of the season. RBI 20. And the Blue Jays lead it 6-0.
Everett got into that one. 3-1 heater right down Broadway. It was a repeat of the pitch prior to it. He got a preview on the 3-0 fastball that he took. And then he got the same pitch on the 3-1 count and deposited that one deep into right field and over the fence. And he couldn't have hit it at a better time, because right as he hit that, the wind stopped blowing in and started a little bit towards the foul line, so it didn't cut it down. He really earned that home run. That ball was pounded.
Derek DeLatte takes it down and out, ball one. Derek has been hit by a pitch. He's reached on a fielder's choice, driven in a run, stolen a base. Denny defies the wind and hammers one out of here. 6-0 Jesuit. Hit hard. First base. Nice play. Luca Salta Famaggio. Flash the leather. Make the play. And one gone.
A big fella showing some mobility down there at first base.
I'm going to highlight that one, buddy.
Yeah, that was a nice play.
Mm-hmm.
Slid to his glove side. Makes the play.
That's what you want to see as a pitcher.
Shortstop. Marshall
Cirio is grounded into a 4-6-3 double play. He has reached on a fielder's choice and stolen a base. Thomas delivers. That is high and away. It is one ball and no strikes. Blue Jays with 5 runs in the second, 1 here in the fourth, with a 6-0 lead over the Tigers. Here's the 1-0. Tap foul at the end of the bat, a breaking ball. It's 1-1. Little pull cue action there.
Like a little cutter. Little cutter from Thomas. Cirio hit that right off the cap.
Now the 1-1. Breaking ball drops in there. A strike called. It's 1-2.
Would get me over a breaking ball right there.
Cirio waiting. Thomas ready. Deep breath in the 1-2, and a swing and a fly ball into right field, slicing right to the right fielder, Sirkovich, for the out. And two gone. Patrick Berrigan bats. He's struck out twice, once swinging and once looking.
That was a fastball up in his own, in on the hands of Cirio. Got jammed a little bit. Routine play for Sirkovich and Wright.
Pitch fouled back to the netting. It's 0-1 on Berrigan.
And even though Thomas has given up the home run, he has come in and he has thrown strikes. We talked about command being an issue for him, but he has done a pretty good job today of throwing strikes.
And a swing and a fly ball, very easy in the center. Forstall waits on it and puts it away. Blue Jays get a run on the home run by Denny, the lone hit.
One run score.
And we have played four with Jesuit on top of Holy Cross.
Jesuit
6-0 here at Kirsch Rooney Stadium. And Marisi will head back to the mound. Don't want to overstate that home run, but it's tough to get it out of here today. And that's probably the only place you can get out of here is close to the line and probably right field side here today.
Yeah, that's the only way, because the wind every once in a while will shift to the point where it's blowing across to the right field line. And that's exactly what happened when that ball was hit. So he didn't get any help from the wind, but it certainly didn't hurt him.
Marisi back to the mound, 66 pitches. Four innings, he has walked just one. He struck out three. It's all about the command, which has been very good. And he'll be working to Lewis, Guerra, and Forstall here in the fifth.
Catcher, Jeffrey Lewis.
Here's Lewis, grounded to the pitcher his first time. Up for a ball. And a strike called, it's 1-1.
That was a better fastball. He got under the first one, that's why it sailed on him. That one, he stayed behind it and threw it a lot better. You can see the difference in the downhill plane on that pitch.
And a strike call. Good pitch, 1-2. A
little change up right there. Watch here. Watch how fast this fastball is going to look.
Ball and two strikes. Down a ball, off speed, 2-2.
Went to the breaking ball after the change up under the zone, just missed. All right, well, he slowed him down a lot. He throws the elevated fastball right here. Should do the trick.
And it's low. 3-2. Or did he call him out? No, he called him out. Had to wait for that signal. And that delayed signal tells us he got him at the knees for out number one. So strikeout number four for Marisi.
Yeah, that was right down
third
Broadway.
Rue Guerra.
It's a situation where the umpire makes the call and then he gives
we can't hear that. Yeah. So we're looking for the sign, the signal. I'm sure it was heard by the masses. That pitch is down and out. Ball one to Guerra. Struck out swinging in the third. And a swing and a ball hit straight up. Foul over toward the Blue Jay dugout, but running out of room. Out of play. Count is one ball and one strike. Guerra will settle back in. And a strike called. Got the high strike there. It's 1-2.
Much to the dismay of the Holy Cross Tiger faithful.
Maybe the zone opening up a little bit. 1-2. And he chased a breaking ball, or did he?
Got to appeal that one.
And they're pointing to first, looking for the appeal, asking, is anybody going to ask? Now they ask, and he's out. Yeah, I would have agreed with that. I thought he probably went around. Took a while to get the appeal, but on the appeal, it's a strikeout of Guerra, and that's on number two, and strikeout number five for Maurice, which gets forestalled to the plate, who has reached on an error, and he is grounded out. And high school baseball in Crescent City Sports is brought to you by Gibbs Construction, a leader in the construction industry in Louisiana and the Gulf Coast for more than 45 years, transforming dreams, visions, and plans into reality. Gibbs Construction. This one just missing for a ball. I know you appreciate Gibbs Construction and Larry Gibbs.
Absolutely. He does wonders for youth baseball and high school baseball in this area. Super guy.
Strike called. It's 1-1. Yeah, just one of the nicest people.
He really is.
Played back in the day at Courier Zoo.
Oh, did he? I didn't know.
Sure did.
I did not know that.
His two sons, of course, outstanding at Jesuit. 1-1 to count the pitch, and time was called here. That would have been a strike, but got time called this time. Trying to slow the pitcher down. Maurice trying to work quickly because he's working well. He's got two quick outs here in the fifth on strikeouts.
Yeah, when you're in a rhythm like he is, you want to get it and go. Get it and go.
1-1 to Forstall, swing on and fouled. And it is 1-2.
It keeps the hitters on their heels. It allows you to set up your pitches better when you do that, when you're working quickly.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like to work too quickly, but you want to stay in a rhythm. I'm not a pitch clock guy, but if you're doing what you're supposed to do, the pitch clock is irrelevant.
A ball and two strikes to Forstall, and another is high, humped up on that fastball. Got under it, and it's 2-2 with two outs. And the next one is a swing and a foul. Just got a piece off the end of the bat to stay alive. Brody hanging tough.
Looked like a changeup.
Mm-hmm. Was off speed.
Was on the corner, off the corner. Good little arm side run with that changeup.
Holding it 2-2. Here's another pitch on the way. Swinging a pop-up left side. Third baseman over Donnelly. And he reaches but can't get to it. Just over the fence, over by the third base dugout.
Into the backdoor breaking ball there.
And it holds at 2-2. Had a lot of protracted at-bats from the Tigers in this game. This will be the seventh pitch of this at-bat. Here it comes. And a swing and a ground ball to short. Handled by Cirio. Throw is right on the money. The inning is over. A 1-2-3 inning. For Maurice, he set down 5 in a row. Let's take a stretch from Greg Sherman Field, Kershorty Stadium, where Jesuit has a commanding 6-0 lead over Holy Cross. That's 5 in the books, Kurt, for Maurice, with only 3 hits allowed and only 1 walk in the game. He's been in command.
Yeah, and that's exactly what he does. I mean, that's his M.O. His M.O. is to get ahead, stay ahead, throw strikes. He doesn't put guys on base. We mentioned the fact that he had a rough outing last time, and that's what he didn't do. He did hit a couple guys. He walked a couple guys, and it allowed Brother Martin to have a lot of traffic on the bases early, and that's what did him in. But you can see today he's a much different pitcher than he was the other night. He's made the adjustments. Looks like he's making a conscious effort to get ahead early in the count and stay ahead. He's also throwing the breaking ball and the changeup more for strikes today than he did in his previous outing.
And if you're thinking in terms of distance, he's in 82 pitches through 5 innings, so he's got a shot to go to the distance here. Back to the mound, Trace Thomas. He's had 8 innings in relief of Ryer Planchard for the Tigers here today. He's done a pretty solid job. Gave up the home run to Denny, but he's been pretty good as Trace Thomas.
Yeah, that's really been the only blemish so far on his stat line.
Connor Donnelly will start the bottom of the fifth inning for the Blue Jays.
Third baseman.
In high school baseball at Crescent City Sports, brought to you by the Lamarck Motor Company in Kenner. Lamarck Lincoln is the only Lincoln Black Label dealership in the market. It's more than ownership, it's membership. Must be a reason. Here's Donnelly.
Third
Right-handed hitter. Protracted crouch, swings and pops it up first base side. Easy play, caught by Salter Formaggio. One pitch, one out for Thomas.
First pitch curveball kind of backed up on Thomas right there.
And sometimes that can be effective.
It can be because it confuses the hitter a bit. You're expecting it to break. You pick up the spin. You think it's going to break away from you, and it winds up backing up into the handle of the bat.
Joe Bosco will bat. He has singled, scored, and into a fielder's choice. He takes this one down and in, ball one.
It's very deceiving when that happens.
The conclusion of this one, Kirk will talk to the winning coach and the winning star of the game. Missing here, 2-0. Close pitch again. Two balls, no strikes. And a ball, it's 3-0. So again, close pitches, but a ball nonetheless. Three balls, no strikes to Bosco. 3-0, that is down and out. So a four-pitch walk, Bosco's aboard. As Thomas issues the walk here. That's the first he's yielded. And we'll get a runner at first base for the Blue Jays, and that is
number
Jack Sheridan.
Jack Sheridan, running at first base.
Sheridan runs at first.
The batter is catcher.
Here's Luke Werling. He's been hit by a pitch, scored a run, and he has singled one of the three hits for the Blue Jays in this game. Each team with three hits, but Jesuit's got a commanding 6-0 lead. They're in the bottom of the fifth. Check of the run of the pitch. Ground ball toward first, foul. Whirling rolls over on one. It's snowballs and a strike. Whirling back in left side. Tigers have turned a double play already in this game. Long look and the pitch, and that is, I guess, high, over but high, and it's 1-1. Ball and a strike. Again, fans thinking that was a strike. Here's the 1-1. That's a strike over the inside edge. It's 1-2. Just like you, I love pitchers that can work inside effectively.
Yeah, you really need to if you're going to be an effective pitcher. It's hard to just stay away all the time.
One ball, two strikes from the stretch, Thomas, and to the plate, and it is down and in, and Brunner almost took off, but scurrying back to the bag is Sheridan, and it's 2-2. Sheridan thought about going on that down read. Good job by Lewis, who's had to block some pitches in this game, hasn't he?
It really has. There were a couple of balls that he really had to come out of his crouch for, too, as well. So he's gotten a workout back there.
Now the 2-2 and a ground ball to second. Speaking of double play balls, second for one, first for two. Second double play turned by the Tigers. Blanchard, Pelican, Salter, Formaggio ends the fifth inning for Jesuit with no runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left. Let's go to the sixth. And it remains 6-0 Blue Jays. On top. Well, they've turned a couple of good 4-6-3s in this game.
They did, and that was Blanchard. He left the mound, goes in to play his normal position at second base, did a nice job fielding that with the backhanded flip, getting it over to Pellegrin in good shape, and Pellegrin firing over to Salter Formaggio to retire the Blue Jays in the bottom of the fifth. So, you know, Thomas works around the walk. And inducing the double play to get out of the inning. So he's keeping him in the game. He's doing his job. Now the Holy Cross hitters need to get something going here against Morisi to give themselves a chance in these last couple of innings.
Well, Jake has faced three hits. He's walked one. He's struck out five and done a terrific job here. For the Blue Jays, he'll face the heart of the order. 2-3-4, Sirkovic, Pellegrin, and Salter Formaggio here in the sixth inning for the Tigers.
These are the guys that need to do it.
So, Maurice finishing his warm-up tosses. Back at it here in the sixth. And he'll be dealing with Cirkovic to get it started. Cirkovic singled in the first. He's also flying out to right.
Right fielder.
As he gets set to settle in. Cirkovic from the right side.
If they can get something going with 2-3-4 here, what it'll allow them to do is flip the lineup over for the seventh. I mean, that's the goal here.
Cirkovic with a ground ball, the second. Easy chance for DeLad. One pitch, one out. So first pitch hunting, nothing doing. And here's Pellegrin. Dom has popped out, and he has singled and stolen a base.
I like the aggressiveness. But if you're going to swing first pitch down 6-0, you better do a little bit of damage.
First pitch to Pellegrin. Smashed down the third base side. Foul. It's 0-1. So they've gone up swinging here in the sixth. Convinced Maurice he's going to be around the plate.
Curveball front side of the plate right there. Pellegrin a little too quick on it. It was really inside. It would have been tough for him to keep that fair.
Swing a smash to center, but right at Brothers. Makes the catch for out number two. Pellegrin hitting on the screws for the second time, but he's out. Two gone quickly here in the sixth. There's Luca Salter-Famaggio, who has struck out, and he's flied to center.
And that's what we talked about with Pellegrin earlier. Really good bat-to-ball skills. You see the breaking ball. He barrels it up. He hits it sharply foul. Then he gets a fastball he can handle. He barrels that up and lines it to center. So good at bat, just nothing to show for it.
Strike called. It's 0-1.
And now you get the high strike, and the Holy Cross fans are fit to be tired today.
Ground ball toward third. That's fair ball. Long throw coming. That's wide. That'll be an infield hit. So that's a base hit for Salter-Famaggio. Donnelly had to wait on a high chop, and it was carrying him not only to the line, but basically a foot in foul territory, and just no real chance to throw out the runner there.
Yeah, real tough play. That ball bounced right over the front corner of the bag.
Took the third baseman,
Donnelly, into foul territory. And there's a little bit of a slope there, too. So he was fighting the slope. He was actually throwing that ball uphill. That's why he airmailed it at first base. Fortunately for Jesuit, it stayed in play and did not go out of play. And Salter-Famaggio had to remain at first base.
Strike called. It's 0-1 to Planchard, who slid to right and walked and takes it down and out. It's 1-1. And a swing and a ground ball left side. Third baseman gets it. Donnelly to second for the force to DeLatte to take care of Holy Cross here in inning number six with no runs and a hit, no errors. One left. They've stranded five. Bottom of the sixth coming. It remains Jesuit 6-0 over Holy Cross. All the Tigers were determined to swing early in the count in that inning.
Well, they were. And like we said, you like the aggressiveness there. But if you're going to swing early, down six, you know you've got to do some damage there, and it's not easy to do today with the wind blowing. And we saw the Pellegrin hit that ball right on the screws, and it was a routine flyout. Cirkovic is at bat, the ground ball is second. That's not what you're looking for there, but I'm okay with him being aggressive there. The rule of thumb that I used to play by. When you're down, you play what you call catch-up. First pitch of the hitter, of the at-bat, is the hitter's. If it's a ball, then you take until you get a strike. But if the first pitch is a good pitch to hit, go ahead, be aggressive, and try to do some damage with it right there.
So we're heading to the bottom of the 6-0 Jesuit Blue Jays, 3 outs away from a win. Thank you. go to the bottom of the sixth. And a 6-0 lead for the Blue Jays. Thomas back to the mound. He's done a good job here in relief, and he's eaten innings and really helped his team out here. Done a solid job. Here's Michael Brothers, who's walked and scored to produce a run and scored a run, and he's flying to left. Here's Brothers. First pitch shows bunt and took a strike. It's 0-1. Again, another game to follow in this outstanding district between Archbishop Rummel and Brother Martin. Later on this evening, scheduled for a 7:30 start. No balls and a strike. Here it comes. And a good breaking ball for a strike called. It's 0-2.
Kind of reminds you of a Legion evening.
A little bit like it back in the day, right?
Mm-hmm.
No balls, two strikes. And the pitch, and just down 1-2. Now, of course, we have the third year forthcoming of our highly successful Crescent City Sports Summer League, which has been a big hit. There's so many schools across this area that participate. 1-2 the count. The next one. Ground ball the second. Blanchard gloves it, throws, got his man, one out. So Brothers retired. And now here's the man of the hour, Jake Morisi. He's flied to center and flied to right. And right about now, he'd just like to get this at-bat over with and get back to the mound, right?
The way he's throwing it, I don't blame him.
Yep, no doubt. Pitcher, he's been good.
Well, Brothers really got down the line well on that ground ball. Gotta like the energy and the hustle there.
Here's Morisi. First pitch. That is a strike called. No balls and a strike on Jake. Straight up defensively by the Tigers. And the 0-1. Chopper toward third, foul. Any good that handles that. It's 0-2. Good coach, good man. And it's in the family. Senior does a good job coaching too. They're good people. 0-2 the count.
He's a lot of fun to be around, I'll tell you that.
Here it comes. Over, but did he get him? Yeah, he got him. We have to wait for that signal. He struck him out looking. Great breaking ball.
I could hear that one for a change. I could actually hear him.
So two gone.
Bring him up.
It just helps us when we see the signal. Here's Everett Denny, who has walked twice, stolen a base, homered. He's had two RBI game. He's been really good. Denny from the left side. Here's the pitch. And he took a strike. It's 0-1. And much credit to Trace Thomas for the performance he's put forth here in relief for Holy Cross.
Yeah, he's held him at bay. I mean, like we said, the only blemish was the homer.
And he's facing that guy right now and delivers down and out 1-1. Guess it's a good idea to keep it away from him after what he did last time.
Yeah, Everett's a good low ball hitter, just like most lefties are. That's where that other fastball was.
1-1 is in hard. He's got another base hit to right. Everett Denny has been on all four times. Some game he's put together. And the Blue Jays have their fourth hit of the game, a two-out single here in the sixth, which will get Derek DeLatte to the plate, who has been hit by a pitch. Grounded into a fielder's choice, stolen a base, and he's grounded
second
out.
Baseman,
a really good play by Salter Formaggio on him in the fourth inning.
That was another fastball middle in and down, and Everett Denny just dropped a head on it.
Denny's there goes the runner, and a swing and a smash down the right field on a fair ball. Right fielder to cut it off. Good job of doing that to keep the runner from scoring. It's a base hit for DeLatte. Good play, Cirkovich. First and third, two outs.
Very good job by Cirkovich getting to that ball, cutting it off. Little slide to the line, keeps it in front. Holds DeLatte to a single. That could have been trouble if that gets by him.
Very much so. And here's Marshall Cirio, who's grounded into a double play.
Marshall Cirio.
Grounded into a fielder's choice, stolen a base and flied to right. A chance here to do some more damage with two outs. And he's got 26 runs driven in. From the stretch to the plate. Good pitch, strike called.
The third baseman's playing in on the grass right here with two outs. I don't understand that. defensive alignment, it's really going to limit his range on anything.
Missing away, it's 1-1.
In the 5-hole. I doubt the 3-hole. The runners on first and third, two outs with a 6-0 lead in the bottom of the six is going to drag bunt.
Sort of first to make sure that Dillat is not running because he can run. Derek with three steals. Here it comes. Down and out. So it's two balls and a strike to Cirio. Blue Jays now with five hits in the game. Runners lead from the corners on 2-1 the pitch. And he checked and he went around, so it's 2-2. Might have been a called strike nonetheless. Good sweeper.
Good breaking
from
ball.
Thomas. Two balls, two strikes, two on, two outs. Thomas to the plate. Swing and a line drive, base hit, center field. Blue Jays increase the lead to 7-0. Great job by Cirio to go down and get that pitch and hit it right where it was pitched.
It really wasn't a bad pitch. It was a breaking ball down, outer half of the plate. Cirio just rode out that front side and poked it into shallow center field to drive in Denny.
Now Berrigan the bat, and he's talking with Kenny Goodlett.
Left fielder, Patrick Berrigan.
Here's Berrigan.
That was just a good approach by Cirio. For you to stay on that breaking ball, you have to be looking for the ball away, hard away, and then adjusting to anything else, and that's exactly what he did.
Down a ball, 1-0 to Berrigan. Seven nothing Jesuit here in the sixth. Berrigan trying to add some more. 1-0 the count on Patrick. Runners lead first and second the pitch. And that's a strike. It's 1-1. One and one the count. The pitch. That's a wild one. Runners are going to advance to second and third. And the count goes to 2-1. Second wild pitch by Thomas.
Kind of feel bad for Thomas. He was one hot away from having a really good outing today, and he's one hit away from having a poor line score. Not that he's pitched poorly. Sometimes the stat line doesn't.
Up and in, pops out of the catcher's glove, runner halfway down the line, but he returns. Pitcher got to the way. They're going to say that hit him. So he's going to trot to first, so it's a dead ball anyway. Berrigan to first to load the bases.
That might be why Jeffrey Lewis missed it.
Sure, yeah, it would make sense, right?
Piece. Just threw it off course enough for him not to be able to glove it cleanly. Like I was saying, sometimes the stat line doesn't tell the story.
No, he did a really good job. I mean, he's had to eat innings, maybe running out of gas a little bit here, but that's now five hit batters by Holy Cross. That's a bunch in one game. Here's Donnelly. He's been hit by pitches twice and scored a run. He's 0-1. And he steps out for the moment.
He's been a magnet today.
You bet. Said, what did I do? He takes it high, ball one.
Good spot here, 1-0 count, bases loaded. Thomas has got to throw a strike here.
Donnelly's driven in 17 on the season. Awaits the 1-0, and here it is. And it is a strike, 1-1.
Little slider on the outside corner, big pitch right there by Thomas.
A ball and a strike. Here's another. Swinging a ground ball, a deep short. Tough chance. Long throw, Pelican. What a play. Now you know why he's committed to Tulane. He made that look easy, Kirk.
He really did. Great play right there. Got around that ball very well. Came in on the run, scooped it up. Long throw on the run, too. It wasn't a short throw. Long throw on the run. Got a lot on it. And got Donnelly out by a good 10 feet.
A run on three hits. No errors, three stranded for the Blue Jays, who have left seven in the game. But speaking of seven, we head to the seventh, and it's 7-0. Jesuit on top. That's a lot of sevens. And we're going to send Kirk down to go talk to the winning coach and to the star of the game. Got to be Jake Morisi at this stage. Everett Denny's been really good, too, but I got to thank Morisi. And I know a pitcher knows how to talk to a pitcher. So all good there, too. So it'll be here in the seventh. Trosclair, Guichard, and Lewis due up for Holy Cross. 90 pitches for Morisi. So he's got 15 to work with here to go the distance here in the seventh inning. We'll get him right at home plate and facing the camera. So all good. Here's Trosclair, has a ringing double, and he's flying to center. First pitch on the way. And that's a strike. It's 0-1. Oh, one misses down and out. It's 1-1 on Trosclair. So barring any changes, Morisi will be our star of the game. And Kenny Goodlett, of course, we'll talk with him as well. Here's the 1-1. Ground ball foul. It's 1-2. On Trosclair. A ball and two strikes. And Morisi with another. Ground ball, deep short. Backhand, nice pick. Cirio, long throw. Stretch there. Got the bag for out number one. Just a good play. Well, we've seen two shortstops each make an excellent play here in the last inning. Two more outs to get for Morisi. The batter will be Guichard, who's struck out and grounded into a fielder's choice.
Aaron Guichard.
Here's Guichard. Guichard, 0 for 2, and he takes a strike. It's 0-1. Swing and a line drive, base hit to left. Guichard. Hammers one to left, fifth hit for the Tigers, who stay alive with one out, a base runner here in the seventh. Jeffrey Lewis will bat.
Catcher, Jeffrey Lewis.
Here's Lewis, double play in order here, would end it. Lewis is grounded out, struck out, takes it way outside of ball. Jesuit bullpen busy, just in case, behind Morisi. One ball, no strikes. Jay Comboy loosening up for Jesuit. Morisi delivers a strike. It's 1-1. Sun actually peeking through a little bit. We haven't seen that today on this cloudy afternoon in Lakeview. A ball and a strike. Another pitch on the way. Down and out. It's 2-1. Two balls and one strike. From the stretch once more. Pitches on the way. Swing and a miss. Powdered him. And it's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Runner first, one out here in the seventh. Morisi from the stretch and to the plate. And a swing and a little looper towards second. Should be caught. It is by DeLette. For the second out, and Morisi and the Blue Jays are one out away. And here is Ruth Guerra, who has batted twice and struck out twice, swinging.
Ruth Guerra.
Last chance for the Tigers. Blue Jays trying to split this two-game series in District 9-5A. Morisi now settling on. Runner goes, pitches a strike, and they let him steal it. It's 0-1, so Ishard takes second. No balls and a strike to Guerra. From the stretch, Morisi to Guerra, and it's down and in, blocked by Whirling. Count is even at a ball and a strike. The 1-1. Breaking ball strike. It's 1-2. Blue Jays are a strike away. One ball, two strikes with two outs here in the seventh. Rue Guerra trying to keep this game alive for Holy Cross. And the 1-2 pitch, and he missed outside. So it's 2-2. Two balls and two strikes. Morisi set and pitching, and he missed down and out. So it's 3-2. Top of the order, a good hitter, Forstall, would be next. Conboy has stopped throwing for Jesuit. Walks toward the dugout. He's ready if he's needed. 3-2 the count. Stretch and the payoff pitch on the way. Ball four, so Morisi can't finish it. Guerra walks, 2 on, 2 outs. Kenny Goodlett looking. He's coming out, and might that be it? Conboy walked toward the dugout. And he heads toward the mound. And that is the pitch count. Right at it. Kenny Goodlett to the mound. Tried to finish it there. 6 2/3. Long conversation at the mound. He'll get a chance to pitch to this hitter. He's got one hitter left based on pitch count. So here's Forstall, who has reached on an error and grounded out twice. Tigers with 2 on, 2 outs. That's only the second walk for Morisi in the game. Here's Forstall. From the stretch, here is the pitch, and there is a ball inside. One ball and no strikes. Now the 1-0 pitch. And a swing, a liner. The first is caught, and this one's over. It's a complete game shutout for Jake Morisi, who has defeated Holy Cross, shutting them out by the score of 7-0 here this afternoon. And a sterling pitching performance, and just a very well-played game by the Blue Jays overall to earn a split in this two-game series, winning this one by the score of 7-0 over the Tigers. What a job by Jake Morisi. 7 innings pitched, 5 hits, no runs. He walked 2, and he struck out 5, going the distance to get his 5th win of the season. And Ryder Blanchard taking the loss for the Tigers, his first of the year, dropping to 3-1. As a result, the game taking 1 hour and 51 minutes to play. Jesuit wins it by the score of 7-0 here this afternoon. And we'll go down to the field to get our star of the game and our winning head coach as well. So with that, we'll wait for Kirk to line him up. So come on, and Kirk, you can take it away. Go right ahead.
We're down here on the winning coach, Kenny Goodwood. Kenny, tough day to play. Wind blowing in, you know, 15 miles an hour. Tough day to score runs. But you guys figured out a way to do it today.
We definitely did. It's good to respond after a tough loss on Saturday. Jake Morisi did a fantastic job, especially in these conditions, letting this defense play. And that's all we ask them to do. And they did a good job today.
They really did. And your catalyst today, Everett Denny. On base all day long, 2 walks, a big home run through the teeth of the wind, and a base hit late in the game to give you a little bit of insurance.
No, he's been solid. Good senior leader. Great day for us. He gave us a great chance to win. Very excited for Everett. And today he got selected to the the All-Star game. So he doesn't even know yet. We're about to tell him. So it was just a good day for Everett.
That is. That's great. Congratulations to Everett. I don't want to steal that thunder from you for giving him the news. But thanks for the interview. We're gonna interview Jake Morisi right now, winning pitcher. Jake, a little bit of a rough outing last time against Rutter Martin, but it looked like you made some adjustments tonight. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yes, sir. My mechanics were a little off, so me and my dad stayed and we worked, and we fixed some of the kinks, and today showed.
Yeah, and we could really tell. It looked like one of the things that you did very well today was use your breaking ball when you did get behind the count, which wasn't much.
Yes, sir. That's a big thing we've been working on. I've been a little inconsistent with it this year, so we're just working on fixing that, and it showed today.
You know, you're a guy who always competes when he's on the mound, low 80s fastball, but the way you pitch, you always make that fastball play up, and I think you really gave the Holy Cross Tigers fits with that today.
Yes, sir. The pitch calling today helped me in my favor. The off speed helped the fastball speed up.
And it's nice throwing when you have the wind at your back, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Just trusting my defense behind me. They played for me good today.
They really did. You've got a great defense. They did a wonderful job, but you did what you had to do today to pace the game and give your team an opportunity to tackle on some runs, work around some struggles early as far as hitting the ball. You got a couple of walks, turned those into some
big innings.
Yes, sir. Just trusting the lineup and everybody behind me.
All right, that's it from Kirk Rooney.
All right, Kirk, thank you very much. Great job, and congratulations to Jake Morisi, Kenny Goodlett, the entire Jesuit Blue Jay team. They did a great job here today to win this game by the score of 7-0 over Holy Cross. Just extremely well done on their part. By the way, next Thursday, April 18th, on Crescent City Sports, it's live coverage of the District 9-5A track and field meet from Tad Gormley Stadium. Coverage begins just before running events get underway at 6 p.m. It's Catholic League track next week on Crescent City Sports, and we certainly look forward to bringing that to you as well, as we bring you so many outstanding high school events throughout the course of the season. And we brought you an outstanding performance by Jesuit here this afternoon as the Blue Jays win it by the score of 7-0. Once again, the totals of the ball game: Jesuit with 7 runs, 6 hits, 1 error, stranded 7, and Holy Cross with no runs, 5 hits, 1 error, left 7 men on base. Jake Morisi, the winner, to improve to 5-2. The loser, Ryder Blanchard, he drops to 3-1. And the time of the game was 1 hour and 51 minutes, and Jesuit wins it 7-0, and the Blue Jays stay in the race for the district title. With the win, they're 18-10, 6-4 in District 9-5A, and the Tigers drop to 12-11, 5-5 in District 9-5A as a result. Jesuit up next will host John Curtis Christian Thursday at 6:30 here at Kirsch Rooney Stadium, and Holy Cross will host Rummel Thursday at 6:30 at Holy Cross Park. So again, our final score here this afternoon, Jesuit 7 and Holy Cross nothing. It's the first of two. We've got another one to come in just a little bit here from Kirsch Rooney. It should be another good one. The battle for first place between Archbishop Rummel and Brother Martin. That's coming up at about 7:20. We'll be back on the air with you for that one. Want to thank Dan Kane, our producer, for doing a great job here this afternoon. Also, Sam Tornator, our camera person, for doing excellent work as well. For Kirk Bollinger, Ken Trahan from Kirsch Rooney Stadium, reminding you our final was Jesuit 7, Holy Cross nothing. Stay tuned. Coming up in just a bit, we'll be back at you with Archbishop Rummel and Brother Martin. Until then, thanks for joining us. Be a good sport. God bless you one and all. Rounding third and heading home. So long.